Okay, so welcome to our last session. Thank you everybody for joining us to a few final sentences. But before we leave you, so we have a very special guest with us, Elad Stefansky, the CEO of The Bridge. Hi Elad, how are you?
I'm great. A little bit hot in Israel right now, but everything is great besides that.
Super hot, definitely. Yeah. And you are the CEO of The Bridge, and maybe we'll present a few slides just to demonstrate what your agency does. And we're in a very good partnership with The Bridge. Please, Elad, tell us about it.
Well, The Bridge is a growing hack agency that specializes in the fintech world. We're giving all the full 360 degrees services from analyzing to creative to media buying any kind of target or goal of any campaign, and we give our customers actually the full package from the strategy till the execution.
Great. So basically you are a one-stop media shop for fintech companies, as I see.
But this is not our USP, if you're asking. This is there are a lot of growing hack agencies that giving the promise of the one-stop shop. But let's talk about our USP, which is all of the company staff are people that came from the traditional advertising and went through the transition once the digital world get into the advertising in 2006. So we are veterans of the traditional marketing and advertising channels, and we are also the pioneers when the digital marketing just entered into the market until now, and when we have all the automated marketing solution and social and etc. So the main USP of the company is actually is the combination and the understanding how to both side audience. We have from one side the fintech company that bring new technologies, new perceptions, new products, maybe new customers, talking to the new generation of customers. And from the other end, we have the traditional players in the market, still possessing most of the capital of the market. And when I worked in Germany in blockchain and crypto company, I actually once had the need to explain to a traditional player, what is blockchain? And after a few minutes of conversation, I understand very quickly that we have a big problem in many sides of explaining new technologies to traditional players. First of all, they don't have patience. They have a big gap of understanding in technologies and terms that maybe more common to us. And since then came the idea to actually build the bridge that will gap the two worlds, which important that they will talk together. So we are actually educate and access media channels on traditional media channels like Bloomberg, for example, and creating new media spots that will educate and explain the terms and the technologies and the advanced world of fintech.
So The Bridge is basically a fintech growth hacking agency that can help bridging the gaps between financial institutions, traditional financial institutions, and innovative fintech startups that are trying to get their attention. So I understand that if there is any fintech startup in the audience that want to expand to new markets, that want to penetrate to and onboard new clients from different regions, so you're a definite person to talk with.
Definitely, and we can we have the advantage of knowing how to talk to both sides and using traditional media channels, which right now I don't see any I don't see a lot of fintech companies. Maybe Ito is in the crowd that did use traditional channels, but most of the company using digital channels, automated marketing, less creative, more exposure, and in this way they will not access the traditional players. We need to be on channels that are already there. We need to explain them in different words, in different terms, in order to connect them and get their attention to our products. And this is what we're specializing.
Elad, that's definitely sounds like a smart move. And our collaboration, Equitech and The Bridge, is definitely giving a new aspect to the digital media and to marketing, to the marketing efforts, as we're working in collaboration, harvesting data in order to leverage the data and the information we have on the fintech space to help these companies, to help the fintech companies to develop a more suitable market approach. So thank you very much, Elad, for being with us. Appreciate your time. And guys in the audience, feel free to contact to Elad or to us if you have any questions, if you want to get more information about ways to connect with the bridge and start working together.
Thank you, Nir.
Thanks, Elad.
Good to be here.
See you next time. For those of you still with us, we of course want to thank you for being with us today, for joining us on stage, and for joining us to the audience. Tal, any final sentences before we wrap it up?
What a ride.
Yeah, exciting annual summit this year, right?
That's a really good way to summarize. We had 50 speakers. We had almost hours of content. I mean, that's remarkable. And we had hundreds of viewers in Airmeet and in all the like social media. It was a blast. So I really enjoyed, and right now we'll move to our next session. And finally, this is something that is not available for the more global members, but I'm happy to say that we'll be moving back to physical events very soon. And as a kickoff, we have a small gathering of the speakers tonight in a physical event. So this is actually very, very exciting to move back to more than a year without events.
With this being said, we wish all the rest of our speakers around the globe and the rest of the attendees around the globe and all the countries to have a fast COVID-19 recovery, to get out of the situation, and hopefully everybody will be able to enjoy physical events like we do in Tel Aviv in Israel. And we want to thank all the participants today, the keynote speakers, the panelists, and of course our great sponsors and partners for allowing this to happen. And Tal, thank you of course for your finest moderation as usual, and I hope to see you very soon on our next event.
Thank you, Nir. It was awesome.